This is a submarine, one of the most technologically advanced vessels in the world. But why do we really need submarines? Well, the idea of a vessel with the ability to take people underwater goes way back in history. Maybe because all life on Earth started underwater. Or maybe because humans are explorers and the depths of the ocean offer yet another world to be explored. The submarine offered a way to venture down below the surface. But mainly, it was used to sink other ships. During the First and Second World War, the submarine strengthened its strategic role and became a fearful weapon. Yet the first submarines weren't much different from other ships. Except for one thing, they could dive. An ability that gave them a huge advantage, the element of surprise. In the 1950s, the next major step was taken in the history of the submarine. Up until then, submarines had hulls similar to surface ships. Now the hulls became adapted to underwater operations. And the role of the submarine changed. Its main purpose was no longer to sink other ships. Now it was also used to gather enemy intelligence and to launch and retrieve special forces. Acting undetected gave new strategic and operational capabilities. The ability to stay submerged offered important insights. But there's one thing more important for a submarine to be undetected, and that is to remain undetected. So how could engineers help the submarine stay under the surface for longer periods? One way was spelt nuclear power, a technology that allowed large submarines to go on missions for months at a time, allowing them to remain undetected in the depths of the sea. The downside was their size, cost, and signature. So could there be another way to generate energy below the surface? This would take away the need to recharge batteries on the surface using diesel engines where the submarine is visible. One of the most proven solutions is the Swedish AIP based on the Stirling principle first put into use in the 1990s. Used in missions for the last 30 years, it has proven to be resilient, easy to maintain, and contributes to an extremely low signature whilst remaining submerged for weeks at a time. So what's the value of operating modern conventional submarines? During decades of development, submarines have evolved from ships that can dive into vessels that can remain undetected for weeks at a time. Their purpose has gone from sinking ships to playing an active role all the way through, from peacetime to times of conflict, protecting civil society. Because they are the ultimate way of acting undetected, they make it possible to gather enemy intelligence without leaving a trace. In escalating conflicts, the enemy can't approach coastal areas without taking a major risk, not knowing where a submarine might operate. By using a submarine fleet, the message is conveyed even in peacetime. A potential enemy must overcome the submarines before reaching the coastline. That is the threshold effect of submarines, making the enemy carefully consider the risks before attacking, and keeping conflicts away from cities and civil society. And finally, locating and incapacitating submarines requires a significant deployment of resources, whilst still being at the mercy of a torpedo. And that's why a submarine is considered a force multiplier. With a limited number of professional sailors, a submarine provides exceptional capability in all scenarios, from peacetime to times of full conflict. In a world where you are always being monitored, the last remaining domain where you can operate undetected is underwater. And from the depths of the seas, submarines are an important asset in keeping the oceans open and safe. Swedish submarine development started early and continues to set the agenda.